Hello everyone, my name is Isabelle Ray-Coquard. I'm a medical oncologist working in the Centre Léon Bérard Lyon, France. I'm also professor of medicine at the University Claude Bernard in Lyon and the current president of the Gineco Group. Today we will speak about HRD testing in ovarian cancer. Over half of the high-grade serous ovarian cancer are homologous recombination deficient due to several molecular abnormalities, including germline or somatic BRCA mutation, but other molecular abnormalities able to drive this homologous recombination deficiency. And so looking to that, we have seen in ovarian cancer with the PARP inhibitor in the first line setting, we have immediately understood how it is important to have a comprehensive genomic profiling also in ovarian cancer. Comprehensive genomic profiling use NGS to analyze hundreds of genes from a tumor sample in the single assay to simultaneously detect all class of genomic alteration and genomic biomarker, including copy number variant, novel and non-fusion, but also tumor mutational burden, microsatellite instability, and much more importantly, HRD genomic instability. Effectively, this test is now mandatory to manage our patients. If we move on a patient case, it's one of my patients. She has 55 years old with an high-grade serous ovarian cancer. We diagnosed the pathology in February 2016. It is a FIGO stage 3C disease. The good news is that the patient received an upfront surgery and was completely resected, but she received, as a standard of care, platinum-based chemotherapy and BEV. We also have the possibility to give a comprehensive genomic profiling, and the results were the patient is BRCA1 mutated and HRD test positive. We have a very good results of the chemotherapy. In June of the same year, we start the maintenance with olaparib and bevacizumab in the POLA1 trial for 2 years. At the end of the maintenance therapy in February 2018, the patient starts the surveillance, and until now, she's good without any relapse. The key takeaways is that all patients now with newly diagnosed ovarian carcinoma should have somatic germline testing to establish the BRCA status and the HRD status. The point is to increase the chance to identify the best candidate for PARP inhibitor, to define the magnitude of the benefit for PARP inhibitor, but also to facilitate patient choice of treatment, including PARP alone or PARP in combination with BEV or BEV alone, and cascade the testing and cancer risk management for germline HRD mutant, more specifically BRCA mutated. And the HRD may be important for stratification in clinical trial, including a new treatment as a DDR or a checkpoint inhibitor in combination with chemotherapy. And so the comprehensive genomic profiling, including HRD testing, can help to identify actionable additional mutation as TMB, RAD51, but also ATM, that could be important for future clinical trial enrollment and to accelerate new therapeutic development. Thank you very much for your attention.